Hey, Shabbat Shalom, brothers and sisters. Let's go ahead and begin this and bow our heads and pray. Yahweh, thank you for allowing us to gather today to study your Torah and to delight in your truth. Yahweh, I ask that you please guide the study today in your spirit and in your wisdom. We thank your Son, Yahushua HaMashiach, whose blood will wash us clean. And I pray all your remnant to be found worthy of his blood, Yahweh, to wash us clean and to make us new. And we thank you, Most High, for giving us this gift. And we praise you, Yahweh. In Yahushua's name we pray. Amen. Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Welcome to Torah Truth Fellowship of Yahusha. I am your host, Brianna, and this is the Torah portion. So, last week I was a little busy, you guys, and I didn't have time to do the Torah portion. But the week before that, we went over chapters 30 through 32, and this week we'll be covering chapters 33 through 35. So, let's go ahead and begin that, you guys. So, if you have your Bible handy, now is the time to go ahead and open it up. Today, we are beginning in Genesis chapter 33, so let's go ahead and read that. And I'll give you guys just a second because I already have my Bible open and ready. It is late and I'm ready for bed. So I'm going to go ahead and start reading Genesis chapter 33. And Yaakov lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, Esau came, and with him 400 men. And he divided the children unto Leah, and unto Rachel, and unto the two handmaids. And he put the handmaids and their children foremost, and Leah and her children after, and Rachel and Yosef hindermost. And he passed over before them, and bowed himself to the ground 7 times, until he came near to his brother. And Esau ran to meet him, and embraced him, and fell on his neck, and kissed him. And they wept. And he lifted up his eyes, and he saw the women and children, and said, Who are those with you? And he said, The children which Elohim has graciously given your servant. Then the handmaidens came near. Then the handmaidens came near, they and their children, and they bowed themselves. And Leah also with her children came near and bowed themselves. And after came Yosef near and Rachel, and they bowed themselves. And he said, What do you mean by all this drove which I met? And he said, These are to find grace in the sight of my Adonai. And Esau said, I have enough, my brother. Keep that you have unto yourself. And Yaakov said, Nay, I pray you, if I have now found grace in your sight, then receive my present at my hand. For therefore I have seen your face as though I had seen the face of Elohim, and you were pleased with me. Take, I pray you, my blessing that is brought to you, because Elohim has dealt graciously with me, and because I have enough. And he urged him, and he took it. And he said, Let us take our journey, and let us go, and I will go before you. And he said unto him, My Adonai knows that the children are tender, and the flocks and herds with young are with me. And if men should overdrive them one day, all the flock will die. Let my Adonai, I pray you, pass over before his servant, and I will lead on softly, according as the cattle that goes before me, and the children be able to endure, until I come unto my El Adonai unto Seir. And Esau said, Let me now leave with you some of the flock that are with me. And he said, What needs it? Let me find grace in the sight of my Adonai. So Esau returned that day on his way unto Seir. And Yaakov journeyed to Sukkot, and built him a house there, and made Sukkot for his cattle. Therefore the name of this place is called Sukkot. And Yaakov came to Shalem, a city of Shechem, which is in the land of Canaan, when he came from Paddan Aram, and pitched his tent before the city. And he bought a parcel of a field where he had spread his tent at the hand of the children of Shamor, Shechem's father, for 100 pieces of money. And he erected there an altar, and called it El Elohai Yasharel. All right, let's go over this really quick. Okay, so in this chapter we see that Esau has come out to meet his brother Jacob, and he brought 400 men with him. And Jacob, he divided his children unto Leah and Rachel and their two handmaids. And he put the handmaids foremost with their children, and then Leah and her children were behind them, and then Rachel and Joseph were at the very back. And Jacob made his way unto his brother, bowing as he came forward. And they hugged each other, and they wept. And Esau asked Jacob, who are all these people with you? And Jacob said, these are my servants and, you know, my children that Yahuwah has blessed me with. And then Jacob brought everyone up to meet Esau, the children. And then Esau asked, what is the meaning of the droves that you sent unto me? And Jacob tells his brother, you know, it's a present from me. If I have found grace in your sight, please keep this gift as a token of my gratitude. And Esau says, well, I have enough. I can't take this. You keep it. And Jacob tells him, no, I have found grace in your sight. Please, you must keep it. He says, seeing how happy and pleased his brother was to see him, it was like seeing the face of Yahuwah and seeing how pleased Yahuwah is. So Jacob says, I pray you, take my blessing that I have brought to you, because Yahuwah has been gracious to me and I have enough with me. So finally Esau is like, all right, and he accepts the gift. And Jacob tells his brother, or no, Esau says to let him go and make his journey. Wait, no. No, okay. Esau wanted Jacob to come to the land of Seir with him. But Jacob is, he's on his own journey right now. And he says, no, I can't do that. He says, you know, where was I? He says, you know, I have children with me. You know, the children, they are tender. And the flocks with me, they have young. And we can't overdrive them or they will die for exhaustion. And he asks Esau to let them pass by. And he will lead his people and his flocks on quietly as long as they be able to endure. And Esau says to Jacob, you know, let me give you some of the flocks that to go with you. And Jacob asked him, you know, what for? If I have found grace in your sight, I've found grace in your sight, haven't I? Why are you giving some of them back to me? So Esau returned to his land of Seir, and Jacob journeyed to Sukkot. And he built him a house there, and he made booths, or Sukkot, for his cattle. Therefore, the name of this place is called Sukkot, and Abraham named it this. It was also the first place of the feast of Sukkot was observed. And then Jacob journeyed to Shalem, which is a city of Shechem. And here Jacob bought himself a field where he built his tent, and it is right outside the city. And he also erected there an altar, and he named it El Elohai Yashareel. All right, let's read chapter 34, you guys. And Dinah, the daughter of Leah, which she bore unto Yaakov, went out to see the daughters of the land. And when Shechem, the son of Shamor, the Shivi, prince of the country, saw her, he took her, and he lay with her, and defiled her. And his soul clave unto Dinah, the daughter of Yaakov, and he loved the damsel, and spoke kindly unto the damsel. And Shechem spoke unto his father Shamor, saying, get me this damsel to be my woman. And Yaakov heard that he had defiled Dinah, his daughter. And now his sons... And now his sons were with his cattle in the field, and Yaakov held his peace until they were come. And Shamor, the father of Shechem, went out unto El Yaakov to commune with him. And the sons of Yaakov came out of the field where they heard it. And the men were grieved, and they were very wroth, because he wrought folly in Yashareel in lying with Yaakov's daughter, which thing ought not to be done. And Shamor communed with them, saying, the soul of my son Shechem longs for your daughter. I pray you, give her to him to be his woman. And ye make marriages with us, and give your daughters unto us, and take our daughters unto you. And ye shall dwell with us, and the land shall be before you. Dwell, and trade ye therein, and get you possessions therein. And Shechem said unto her father, and unto her brethren, let me find grace in your eyes, and what ye shall say unto me, I will give. Ask me never so much dowry and gift, and I will give according as ye shall say unto me. But give me the damsel to be my woman. And the sons of Yaakov answered Shechem and Shamor his father deceitfully, and said, because he had defiled Dinah their sister. And they said unto him, we cannot do this thing to give our sister to one that is uncircumcised, for that were a reproach unto us. But in this will we consent unto you, if ye will be as we be, that every male of you be circumcised. Then we will give our daughters unto you, and we will take your daughters unto us, that we will dwell with you, and we will become one people. But if ye will not hearken unto us to be circumcised, then we will take our daughter, and we will be gone. And their words pleased Shamor and Shechem, Shamor's son. And the young man deferred not to do this thing, because he had delight in Yaakov's daughter, and he was more honorable than all the house of his father. And Shamor and Shechem his son came unto the gate of their city, and communed with the men of the city, saying, These men are peaceable with us, therefore let them dwell in the land, and trade therein. For the land, behold, it is large enough for them. Let us take their daughters to us for women, and let us give them our daughters. Only herein will the men consent unto us for to dwell with us, to be one people, if every male among us be circumcised, as they are circumcised. Shall not their cattle and their substance and every beast of theirs be ours? Only let us consent unto them, and they will dwell with us. And unto Shamor and unto Shechem his son hearkened all that went out of the gate of his city. And every male was circumcised, all that went out of the gate of his city. And it came to pass on the third day, when they were sore, that two of the sons of Yaakov, Shimon and Levi, Dinah's brethren, took each man his sword, and came upon the city boldly, and slew all the males. And they slew Shamor and Shechem his son with the edge of the sword, and took Dinah out of Shechem's house, and went out. The sons of Yaakov came upon the slain, and spoiled the city, because they had defiled their sister. They took their sheep, and their oxen, and their asses, and that which was in the city, and that which was in the field, and all their wealth, and all the little ones, and all the women took they captive, and spoiled even all that was in the house. And Yaakov said to Shimon and Levi, Ye have troubled me, to make me stink among all the inhabitants of the land, among the Canaanim and the Perazim. I being few in number, they shall gather themselves together against me and slay me, and I shall be destroyed, I and my house. And they said, Should he deal with our sister as with a harlot? Okay, let's go over it. All right, chapter 34. So Dinah, the daughter of Leah and Jacob, she went out into the land of Shechem, whatever, to see the daughters of the land and to, you know, go make friends. And Shechem, the daughter of Shamor, the Shivi, the prince of the country, saw Dinah, and he immediately lusted after her, and he took her, and he defiled her, and he was kind to her, and he most likely took advantage of her by being so kind to her, and his soul cleaved to her because of his lust. So he tells his father, you know, you must get this woman for me, you must talk, her father into marriage. But word had already gotten to Jacob about what had been done to his daughter, but he held his peace until he spoke with the men. So they went out to commune with Jacob, and his sons came out to meet Shechem and his father Shamor. And Dinah's brothers, they were very angry about what happened to their sister, because he did something that is forbidden. So they all communicated together, and Shamor asked Jacob, you know, my son Shechem, he would really like to marry your daughter. Please give your daughter to him, and we'll give our daughters to you. And he said, we'll give you whatever you want, whatever you ask me for, it'll be yours. Just please give me your daughter in marriage. And Jacob's sons dealt deceitfully with Shechem and Shamor. And they said, we'll give her to you on one condition, that you all become circumcised like we are. You and all the men that are in your gates of your city must all be circumcised, and then we can dwell together. And Shechem and Shamor, they were pleased at hearing this, and they agreed to the terms. So later that evening, Shamor and Shechem communed at the gates of the city, saying, These men are peaceable with us. Let them dwell and trade in our land. Behold, it's big enough for us. It can sustain us all. And we'll take their daughters, and they'll take ours. And they will consent to dwell with us if every man becomes circumcised like they are. And should not their cattle and their substance and every beast of theirs be ours too? So you see what they were doing, what they were going to do here, right? They were eventually going to overrule them, Shechem and Shamor. So they were dealing deceitfully as well. It came to pass that on the third day after their circumcision, you know, they were all feeling really sore. And the sons of Jacob, Shimon and Levi, they took their swords and they went out into the city and they slew all the men. And then they took all the women and children captive, and they took all the cattle for themselves. And Jacob was really angry with his sons for doing this. He said, "You have brought trouble to my house, and you have made me stink upon all among all the inhabitants of the land, among the Canaanim and the Perazim. And they are many in number, and I am just but a few." He said, "They are going to gather against me now and slay me. They will destroy me and all of my house." And they said to their father, "So are we supposed to let this man deal with our sister like she's a harlot?" All right. Chapter 35. And Elohim said unto El Yaakov, "Arise and go to Baal and dwell there, and make there an altar unto Elohim that appeared unto you when you fled from the face of Esau your brother." Then Yaakov said unto his household and to all that were with him, "Put away the strange Elohi that are among you, and be clean, and change your garments, and let us arise and go up to Baal, and I will make there an altar unto Elohim, who answered me in the day of my distress, and was with me in the day which I went." And they gave unto El Yaakov all their strange Elohi which were in their hand, and all their earrings which were in their ears, and Yaakov hid them under the oak which was by Shechem, and they journeyed, and the terror of Elohim was upon the cities that were round about them, and they did not pursue after the sons of Yaakov. So Yaakov came to Luz, which is in the land of Canaan, that is Baal, and he and all the people that were with him, and he built there an altar, and called that place El Beit El, because there Elohim appeared unto him, when he had fled from the face of his brother. But Deborah, Rivka's nurse, died, and she was buried beneath Beit El under an oak. And the name of it was called Alan Bakuth. And Elohim appeared unto El Yaakov again, when he came out of Paddan Aram, and blessed him. And Elohim said unto him, "Your name is Yaakov. Your name shall not be called anymore Yaakov, but Yasharel shall be your name." And he called his name Yasharel. And Elohim said unto him, "I am El Shaddai. Be fruitful and multiply. A nation and a company of nations shall be of you, and kings shall come out of your loins. And the land which I gave Abraham and Yitzhak, to you will I give it, and to your seed after you will I give the land." And Elohim went up from the place where he talked with him, and Yaakov set up a pillar in the place where he talked with him, even a pillar of stone, and he poured a drink offering thereon, and he poured oil thereon. And Yaakov called the name of the place where Elohim spoke with him Beit El. And they journeyed from Baal, and there was but a little way to come to Ephrath. And Rachel travailed, and she had a hard labor. And it came to pass, when she was in hard labor, that the midwife said unto her, "Fear not, you shall have this son also." And it came to pass, as her soul was in departing, for she died, that she called his name Ben-Oni, but his father called him Benjamin. And Rachel died, and was buried on the way to Ephrath, which is Beit Lashem. And Yaakov set a pillar upon her grave. That is the pillar of Rachel's grave unto this day. And Yasharel journeyed and spread his tent beyond Migdal Eder. And it came to pass, when Yasharel dwelt in that land, that Reuben went to lay with Bila, his father's concubine. And Yasharel heard it. And now the sons of Yaakov were 12. The sons of Leah, Reuben, Yaakov's firstborn, and Shimon, and Levi, and Yehuda, and Yishakar, and Zuvalin, and the sons of Rachel, Yosef, and Benjamin, and the sons of Bila, Rachel's handmaid, which is Dan, and Naphtali, and the sons of Zilpah, Leah's handmaid, Gad, and Asher, and these are the sons of Yaakov, which were born to him in Paddan Aram. And Yaakov came unto El Yitzhak his father, unto Mamre, unto Kiryat Arba, which is Chevron, where Abraham and Yitzhak sojourned. And the days of Yitzhak were 84 years, and Yitzhak gave up his ruach and died, and was gathered unto his people, being old and full of days, and his sons Esau and Yaakov buried him. All right, let's go over it real quick. Okay, in this chapter, Yahuwah tells Jacob to get his people and to go to Baal, also known as Bethel. and dwell there and make an altar there for Yahweh. And this is the place Yahweh first spoke with Jacob when he fled from his homeland because his brother was going to kill him. And Jacob then tells everyone in his household to put away the strange Elohai and be clean and change your garments, because the children of Laban were not clean. They worshipped idols and teraphim. Remember we talked about that. Rachel, when they left the land, Rachel stole one of her father's teraphim. Be clean of heart. How could Jacob know what clean of heart is without the Torah? So the people gave Jacob their graven images and their jewelry, and he buried them under an oak tree in Shechem. And they journeyed, and the terror of Yahweh was upon the cities as they passed, so no one pursued Jacob and his sons. And Jacob arrived in Luz, which is in Canaan, which is now called Beit El or Bethel, where Yahweh also appeared unto Jacob when he came out of Paddan Aram, Laban's land. And Yahweh blessed him and said, "Your name is Jacob, but you shall no longer be called Jacob. You shall now be called Israel." And Yahweh said, "I am El Shaddai, Yah Almighty. Be fruitful and multiply, and a nation and a company of nations shall come out of your loins. You will inherit the promise which I promised to your father Abraham and Isaac. And I will give it to you and your seed after you." And after that, Jacob set up a pillar of stone, and he poured out drink offering on it and oil. And Deborah, Rebekah's nurse, died there in Beit El, in Bethel. Rebekah is Jacob's mother, remember, who is also dead. And they buried her nurse under the oak tree there in Beit El. And that place was called Alan Buka, Bakuth, yeah, the oak of weeping. And they journeyed from Beit El to Ephrath, but they weren't quite there yet, and a very pregnant Rachel went into labor before they got there, and she had a very, very hard labor, and her midwife told her that she was having another son, and that it'll come to pass she'll have this son also. And it came to pass that as she was delivering him, her soul was departing, she was dying. And before she died, she called him Ben Oni, or son of my pain. But Jacob called him Benjamin, which means son of the right hand. And after this, they buried Rachel in Beit Leshem, or Bethlehem. And Jacob made a pillar there for Rachel, and the pillar for her burial site still stands to this day. And then Jacob and his sons, they journeyed, and they made their tents in Migdal Eder. And while they were in this land, Reuben, Jacob's oldest son, lay with his concubine, Bilhah, and Jacob heard of this, and he was upset with his son, because this is commanded against. And Jacob had 12 sons, the sons of Leah, which were Reuben, his firstborn, Shimon, Levi, Judah, Yishakar, and Zebulun, and the sons of Rachel, Joseph, and Benjamin, and the sons of Bilhah, Rachel's handmaid, Dan and Naphtali, and the sons of Zilpah, Leah's handmaid, which are Gad and Asher. And they were all born to him in the land of Paddan Aram, Rachel and Leah's father's country. And Jacob finally made it back to his father Isaac in the land of Mamre, which is in Kiriath Arba in Chevron, Abraham's home. And shortly after Jacob made it back to his father unfortunately yielded up the Ruach, or in layman's terms, he died. And after that, he was gathered onto his people, and they buried him, Jacob and Esau, together. So, all right, guys, that wraps up this week's Torah portion. It was kind of pretty brief this week. As we get into the later chapters in Genesis, and especially once we get into Exodus, the studies will be a little more extensive. So, and don't forget, you guys, if you haven't yet, check out my group on Facebook. You can stay up to date with what we're doing. And don't forget to check out the guides that I've created within that group as well. They are great for those of you who don't know where to start with all of this. So let's go ahead and close up with a prayer, guys. Yahweh, thank you for allowing me to teach your Torah and to speak your testimony as it was written. And I pray my brothers and sisters diligently seek you in these days, Abba. I pray that they ask for your wisdom, and I pray that you reveal it to them, Yahuwah. I pray they find your son, Yahusha HaMashiach. And I pray they understand that we are to mimic him. And most of all, I pray that we are protected by his blood and are delivered to your salvation. Guide us, Yahuwah, in the way that we should go, and provide for my viewers. We praise you, the Most High. In Yahushua's name we pray. Amen. All right, brothers and sisters, I will see you again next week. Everybody enjoy the rest of their Shabbat and Shalom.